More news tonight. Heavy rain forces creeks out of their banks.
And it also created a dangerous situation in Overland Park. KMBC 9's Chris Nagus is live. Chris?
Laura, still a little light rain falling out here in Kansas City. Brian Busby telling me anywhere from 2 to 5 inches of rain. If you have a rain gauge, you probably already know that. I'm told up to 4 inches of rain fell in Johnson County, and that pushed creeks to their banks.
On a dreary night, the traffic above might not notice the water below. Indian Creek is out of its banks. A nature trail disappears underneath the high water. But this scene did not compare to this scene in Overland Park. A concrete culvert might look like a tempting water slide.
As a kid, I used to play around that area. It was actually quite dangerous.
Dana Holstrin knows better now. So does a young teen. The warning signs are there, but a boy still ended up in this rushing water.
And it goes almost directly at a 45-degree angle straight into the sewer and then pushes you straight out to the creek.
And it doesn't take much to get swept away.
It's almost like the speed belt. It's like, you know, riding down like, you know, whitewater rafting. It's got that same velocity.
Witnesses watched the boy float by. They called 911. But before paramedics arrived, the teen was safe. According to the fire department, the boy grabbed a branch and pulled himself out, something Dana Holstrin remembers doing years ago.
When I had done it before, I was able to stop myself. There was little ditches and trees and stuff, you know, stuck in there.
And the good news out of all of this, that young teen was not injured. We are told that he saw a paramedic at the scene and he was released, but still it serves as a good reminder to stay away from creeks and culverts on rainy nights like tonight. Reporting live, Chris Nagus, KMBC 9 News.
Thank you, Chris. Well, the fear of flooding in the Northland tonight has subsided, but take a look at the pictures of the rainfall in Farley, Missouri. The roads were wet, but there were no reports of any serious accidents. The Platte River was also moving along, and the Sheriff's Department said it was watching the levels, but the river did not get close to flooding.
We also got word there may be flooding trouble near Parkville. Safety officials there were monitoring the Walnut Creek Bridge. People ran from the rain, but not because of high water. Missouri River levels did rise tonight, but we're happy to report they did not spill over the bank.
You know, we'll check back with Chief Meteorologist Brian Busby for an update just a little later.
And of course, 24 hours a day, you can count on KMBC.com for the latest weather information.